Estonians have had a distinct culture for centuries, although the nation of Estonia did not exist until 1918. In 1869, a tradition of a massive singing festival held every 5 years called Laulupidu was established, and still goes on. In the words of conductor Venno Laulu, the song festival for us is not only a musical event where we hear our best songs, but it was and still is primarily an opportunity to experience that we are Estonians. This is the story of how a tiny nation held off a massive oppressor, not with weapons, but with song. This is the story of Estonia. In 1939, the Soviet Union signed a non-aggression treaty with Nazi Germany, known as the Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact, referred to as the MRP from now on. A secret protocol of the pact left Estonia open to Soviet takeover, and on June 21, 1939, the Estonian Soviet Socialist Republic was proclaimed. The next year, the Germans turned on the Soviets and brought their own regime to Estonia. By 1944, after winning World War II, the Soviets were back, bringing mass executions and deportations. Estonia was now devastated by the two powers. As a form of propaganda, Laulupidu was inverted to a celebration of the Soviet Union. Until 1969, Soviet censors had not noticed when the choir sang the national anthem, Mu Isama on Minu Arm, My Native Land, My Joy, My Delight. That year, the people sang it. After 1956, Russian workers were brought in to strip Estonians of their culture. They were effective in this position because they fully believed that Estonia should be a part of Russia. In 1985, Mikhail Gorbachev became the General Secretary of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union. He introduced a campaign of massive reforms to address a number of problems. Key among these was the idea of glasnost, freedom of speech.
He made one very basic fundamental mistake. He didn't realize that whenever you give free speech to people, then things get out of hand. The ghost gets out of the bottle.
But the Estonians here that had their own goals, they thought, ah, our big chance. If we are going to change something, okay, let's do it. Let's do it the real way. Let's do it our way. And of course, that wasn't exactly what Gorbachev had in mind.
Spring 1987, a strip mining project for phosphates put glasnost to the test. Activists organized protests on the grounds that the project would be harmful to the environment and potentially contaminate a major water reservoir. By staying non-political, protesters of the phosphate spring were able to stop the mining and opened a gateway for further protests. The next major protest in August 1987 was against the legality of the MRP. Although the permit to assemble in the Tallinn town square was revoked at the last minute, thousands of protesters were allowed to move down the street to Hiidre Park, and a new organization, the MRP AEG, was formed. Soon the Estonian Heritage Society was formed, and the Estonian National Independence Party replaced the MRP AEG. The two are referred to together as radicals. Spring 1988, the illegal blue, black, and white flag began to appear. Two new organizations emerged, the Popular Front of Estonia, PFE, which pursued autonomy within the Soviet system, and Interfront, a response by Russian colonists to the growing independence movement. In June 1988, nighttime demonstrations began at the Laulupidu grounds. For 3 nights, tens of thousands of people came out to sing along to patriotic rock music, earning the name Singing Revolution from Heinz Valk. Karl Vaino, first secretary of the Communist Party of Estonia, the CPE, was dismissed on June 15, 1988 because the Kremlin feared that he could become dangerous. Vaino Velius became the new head of the CPE and immediately began radical reforms. The flag was made legal and Estonian the official language of the Republic. Come September, a more traditional singing event was organized by the PFE. Called the Song of Estonia, 300,000 people came to sing traditional music and hear patriotic speeches. The next day, the radicals began registering citizens of Estonia. In a few months, nearly every adult had registered. The newly made citizens then organized an elected congress, which met for the first time on March 11, 1989. A new MRP debate was now beginning. Gorbachev honestly believed that the secret protocol was a falsification and assigned a committee to investigate it. When he was proved wrong, he killed the issue. The people, however, didn't let it go that easily. On August 23rd, 1989, the anniversary of the MRP, over a million people joined hands in a human chain from Tallinn in the north to Vilnius in the south. The event received international news coverage. In May 1990, the Supreme Council, the legislature of the Communist Party, legalized the hammer and sickle flag and removed the etonpe, the main government building. The next day, Interfront gangs mobbed the building. When Interfront became violent, Prime Minister Edgar Savisaar got on the radio. Thousands of people came to block in the demonstrators, and after Interfront called off the protest, demonstrators were allowed to leave. August 19th, 1991, Stalinists staged a coup in Moscow. 80 tanks were ordered to Tallinn. In the confusion, the Supreme Council invited Congress leaders to write a resolution on the national independence of Estonia. The tanks arrived at the Tallinn TV tower, the main news source for most of Estonia. Two unarmed policemen were dispatched to defend the tower. They watched as the resolution passed unanimously at 11:03 p.m. August 20th, 1991. Thousands of unarmed civilians came to the tower, and the policemen threatened to use the tower's fire extinguishing system to kill everyone in the building if the army attacked. For 18 hours, the army waited for orders. In these 18 hours, the coup consumed itself, the leaders were arrested, Boris Yeltsin legalized the Communist Party in Russia, and the army was ordered home. Immediately that month, the three Baltics were accepted to the United Nations, and the last statue of Lenin was toppled. A new constitution was drafted and adopted by referendum in 1992. It established a legislature, an executive branch, and a judicial branch of government. Also in 92, a new citizenship law was created. It was considered discriminatory toward Russians in Estonia and eventually changed at the European Union's request. In 1991, still under Savisaar, businesses that the Soviets had seized were made available to workers. When he was replaced by Tiit Vähi in 92, the system was changed so that any investor could buy any business. Vähi also created financial regulations and replaced the ruble with the traditional krona. In 93, Mart Laar became prime minister and established a hybrid of the systems. Throughout, farms had been decentralized, and by 1998, Estonian rural living standards were equal to those of Scandinavia. Also in 93, Finland replaced Russia as Estonia's largest trade partner, although Russia still depended on Estonia for 25% of its freight, and Estonia was now able to charge world market prices for transportation. Because of Estonia's economic success, the EU signed a trade agreement in 1994 without the transitional period applied to Latvia and Lithuania. That year, the last of the Russian army left Estonia. Although people still accuse Estonians of being racist to Russians, many believe that the argument goes the other way. In 2004, Estonia fully joined the EU, as well as NATO. Estonian troops began fighting in Afghanistan, marking a full political transition to Europe. In 2007, visa-free travel was introduced on Estonia's north and south borders. Because of this and ongoing restoration of neglected buildings, tourism is a flourishing industry in Estonia. Because of the reaction to Glasnost, Estonia was able to slowly escape Soviet control. After the formal revolution, fast reforms ensured that this escape would be permanent, and that Estonia will stay a free nation. In modern Estonia, music is still important. Estonian pop musicians are known for doing well in the popular Eurovision Song Contest. More importantly, Laulupidu remains a large focus. Every 5 years, 30,000 people come to Tallinn to celebrate the one thing they all have in common. They are Estonians. Come on, everybody, sing along and feel the power of a song. Come on, everybody, feel the pride that always lives within.